sunny Fort Lauderdale, Florida, a vacationer's paradise. Here, boaters enjoy a relaxing cruise along the Stranahan River as it flows to the Atlantic Ocean. But the calm appearance of this waterway is deceptive. Rising and falling tides cause a strong current that can be hazardous to boaters. On this glorious spring afternoon, the U.S. Coast Guard boat 41351 is patrolling these waters. Bosun's mate, third class Matthew Goodnow, is the coxswain commanding the utility boat. His five-person crew includes auxiliarist Frank Morrow and seaman apprentice Dwight Higgins. The crew heads to a dock a few hundred yards away from the 17th Street Causeway Bridge. After they tie up, Seaman Higgins suddenly spots trouble on the water.
And I kept looking closer and closer, and I was like, it kind of looks like a boat is going down.
In fact, a 25-foot Bayliner filled with 8 adults and 3 children is taking on water fast. As he watches from the dock, Coxswain Goodnow moves into action.
I saw the boat struggling, and I told my crew to get on the boat, get the pumps out, because I figured by the time I get over there, I could save the boat.
To the scene as, caught in the current, the pleasure boat heads toward a moored barge. The 25-foot Bayliner collides with a giant steel vessel. A passenger tries to push away. Instead, the boat seems to sink even faster, as if it's being pulled under the barge. A passing boat tries unsuccessfully to help, but it's too late. The Bayliner is crushed, and its passengers must now escape any way they can. Goodnow and his crew can see the situation is now extremely serious. With sirens blaring, Goodnow steers the 41 to the barge.
I was just worried about running over people. This is mass confusion.
How many? Oh, man, he's under.
Goodnow gives the okay for crew members to jump into the water.
I'm never supposed to put a crew member in the water unless he's fully equipped with a harness and attached to a line. I figured I'd just, you know, do it my way, get it done, save the most amount of people as we can, and then deal with the consequences later.
Panicked screams stun bystanders. Even Seaman Higgins is frightened.
I was really scared because I never had been in a situation quite like that before, to where, you know, I knew that more than likely, someone was going to die.
Even so, Higgins jumps into the water, but he's immediately caught in the current and swept under the barge.
It was kind of like being in a whirlpool. I was just constantly twisting, and I hit my head. I can't see anything. It's totally black. I can't hear anything. The only thing I hear is just the water running by my ears.
Oh, man, he's under.
Auxiliarist Frank Morrow is already in the water.
I happened to be right where this one little girl was, like, stuck under the barge, drifting under the barge. She was looking her in the eye and screaming for help, so I just went for her. The little girl was hanging on to me, and I had her father and another guy and her aunt. And they were all panicked.
Seaman Higgins is still in his own life and death struggle under the barge. Coxswain Goodnow fears the worst as he steers the 41 to the barge's side and then ties it off.
My worst fear is maybe this wasn't the right decision and, you know, everything's going to go wrong.
Goodnow worries their heroic intentions may not only fail to save the tourists, but prove fatal to his crew as well. People on the shore watch in horror as a pleasure boat sinks. Other boaters try to help. In desperation, 4 U.S. Coast Guard crewmen have jumped into the fast-moving water in an attempt to save the 11 drowning passengers. As Coast Guard coxswain Matthew Goodnow secures the 41 to the barge, he is worried about his crew.
When the crew jumped in, they all kind of scattered in different directions because the current took them. Higgins went right under the water, so I was worried that I had already lost him.
Seaman Higgins fights for his life in the incredibly strong current. Miraculously, he makes it to the surface.
As I was pushed out from underneath the barge, I saw a lady being swept by in the current. And I told her, grab onto the piles, whatever you can. It was hard for her to understand me because I had swallowed a lot of water. My throat was burning.
Suddenly, again, Seaman Hagens is sucked under the barge.
I'm actually spinning around in a circle and kind of going head over heels at the same time in all different directions, fighting for air. And I put my arms up and I felt the bottom of the barge. And I pulled and I kept pulling and I could feel the barnacles cutting into my hands, ripping me open. And I pulled until I came out again. And I came out right where the lady was at in the pilings.
Hagens and the woman cling to the pilings. An offshore towing vessel offers assistance and gives Hagens a life jacket for the frightened woman. Within moments, they are pulled out of the water to safety. Hagens has suffered a concussion, a gash in his head, and cuts on his hands. But his only concern is for the tourists.
How many do you have?
Sadly, the accident claimed the lives of two German tourists. But the remaining nine passengers were saved. The Florida Marine Patrol investigation into the sinking revealed that a large wake from another boat splashed into the Bayliner, swamped the bow, and pushed the stern out of the water. This made the boat impossible to steer. At the same time, the tide was going out, causing an incredibly strong current running at almost 10 miles per hour. The current then pulled the partially submerged boat into the moored barge. The passengers didn't know that the empty barge was floating right on the water's surface, and in these conditions, the current would drag anything in the barge's path directly underneath it.
So the current's actually running right under the barge. Instead of around it, it's running right underneath it. So things would float to the barge and then we go right under the barge. They wouldn't go around it.
Today, Frank Morrow, Dwight Hagens, and Matt Goodnow still patrol Fort Lauderdale's waterways. After a thorough review of this difficult rescue, the crew of Utility Boat 41 was honored by the Coast Guard for their heroism in saving nine lives.
I joined the Coast Guard to basically save as many lives as I could. This was everything that I ever hoped for when I joined the Coast Guard, for this one chance to save this many people.
A split-second decision made the difference between life and death and reflected the courage of the Coast Guard and their commitment to saving lives.